to ensure that people within Ghana and in the West Africa zone will promote consumption of our local produce. And on the 14th of February, as we've celebrated since the initiative by His Majesty Jake Otaka of blessed memory, a creative genius, we have managed successfully to associate chocolate with St. Valentine. And I must say, it has been very successful. Very, very successful. It is an event that is traveling beyond Ghana, National Chocolate Day. But we need to beef it up. And as you've noticed, this year, segueing into our policy of See Ghana, Eat Ghana, and Wear Ghana, it's such an apt marriage. We are promoting domestic tourism, but we are also aggressively promoting cocoa consumption. And we have to applaud the fluid collaboration with our partners from Cocoa Board, CBC, and all the other agencies in between who are supporting this laudable idea. What we do at the ministry is to give policy guidelines to support our vibrant agencies under us. And the two most significant policies that you will see a lot of this year is aggressively marketing Ghana as a preferred destination in West Africa and eventually in the entire continent. We have some stiff competition in the continent. If you do Africa, Kenya, South Africa. But if you niche West Africa, Ghana stands very tall. So we are really aggressively marketing, and we can do that only with the support of the people of Ghana Tourism Authority and other agencies in the process. That is why I'm here, to support this lunch, because if every guest who stays in a hospitality entity in the country gets to eat chocolate, I can't say golden tree because we have other, but chocolate. As we've noticed in other jurisdictions, when they turn down the bed, you will see a little chocolate by the bed. We can and we will enjoy Gatoff to ask the hotels to promote the Eat Chocolate starting February 14th throughout the year, that when you go to hotels, as a guest gets up, they should see a little chocolate bar to welcome them. That is a very simple and seamless way of promoting our cocoa. And I'll ask them to supply it to the hotel. And as they see the consumption increase, maybe charge a little token. It can be done. It is our cocoa, our Ghana. We should be able to ask GTA to add this to the regulations and softly ask CPC to give us this sample cocoa that they give us when we travel abroad to put it in the hotels. We are over 2,700 hotels. Imagine each getting about 500 little samples to give to guests. It will go a long way to push the consumption effort. Secondly, as a ministry, we pride ourselves in standards, regulations. That is why the awards are very important to us as a sector. We need to set the highest standards to emulate international best practices. So the National Tourism Award, a mainstay of the sector, is something that we want the media to support us in propagating, and also play the watchdog. When you visit entities, when you go to hotels, eateries, and you see something untoward, be the citizen vigilante and send it to us. Very soon we'll set up a call center here, and you'll be able to call in and tell us, I went to this restaurant, the water they're using is not clean, the gardens behind is so dirty. Share these kinds of things with us to help us upgrade standards so Ghana as a preferred destination will meet international standards. One of the very big surprise for National Chocolate Day is I'll join my brother JB to do the competition. He has the JB special recipe, and we will cook achaka with chocolate. So we will cocoa the achaka. And I think it will be an awesome day. We enjoin you to spread the word. Let the people of Ghana know that if we don't practice what we preach, it will be difficult to sell. They say charity begins at home. Our theme is eat Ghana, eat chocolate. Buy chocolate as a gift to your loved ones, your friends, on 14th February. And don't let it be a one-day event. Make it an agenda to put a smile on someone's face when you give them a gift of chocolate. It is a sign of love, a sign of friendship. And we have, I must say, congratulate GTA that we have managed to also curb a lot of indecent attitude and behavior on Valentine's Day, because we have aggressively overshadowed the revelers with consumption of chocolate. And we should applaud the efforts of GTA in partnership with Cocoa Board, CPC, and all the other agents. My mission is to ensure that the consumption does not only stick to 14th of February. That is why for the last 9 months, we have put together a team. We have done our feasibility studies. We have had our designs. And by the grace of God, with the support of my friends here, Cocoa Board and CPC, we will cut the sword to establish Tetekwashi Cocoa Mission. And it is something in line with the vision of His Excellency Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, that local consumption must be promoted. And we can do that when you have a place to go 365 days of the year to sample cocoa, see what a pod looks like. And Mr. Joseph Amate, Youth Ambassador, this is a charge for you. So students will be bussed there once completed to see what a pod looks like, what a cocoa tree looks like, the process it goes through to the bar. So from pod to bar, our young ones and adults will appreciate it. So that is a charge for you. I know the good people of Mampo are waiting for us to do the needful. So I have tasked GTA today. Wisdom's name came up. Right after this launch, you will be going to Mampo to meet the family, the kings and the queens of that area, to officially tell them of the date that we will be coming there. We are Africans, we are Ghanaians, and we respect tradition. So they will go there today and do the knocking as the families, their date that is appropriate, so we can come and do the customary rites as appropriate and commission this laudable project, which again is in line with honoring our heroes. You heard recently Dr. Pa Grant's name was attached to Tapa, the school. And then we just had yesterday Dr. Hila Liman attached to the UDS in Wa. And now Tetekwashi Cocoa Museum will also come. It's all an effort by His Excellency to honor our founding fathers who have sacrificed to get us to where we are. A nation that you die for must recognize and honor you. So with that said, without much ado, I will ask each and every one of you here to join me to say the catchphrase, I hereby duly launch the National Chocolate Day and the National Tourism Awards.